Okay, so now what I've done is I've gone to the Gaussian Naive Bayes documentation page. sklearn.naivebayes.gaussiannaivebayes. This was the algorithm that I set out to find, and now I've found the SKlearn documentation page. So the first thing that I see right here, actually this is one of the things I love about the SKlearn documentation, is it's full of examples. When I was actually developing the code for this class, this was one of the first things that I would always do, is I would come find the example code and I would try to just run it in my Python interpreter to see if I could get it working. And almost invariably, it works right out of the box. So here's something that's just very simple. There's only a few lines here that are really important. So let me point them out to you, and then I'll show you the code that I've actually written for the example that we just saw, and you'll start to recognize some of these lines. But first, let's introduce them. So the first one that's really important is this one right here. Above this, it's just creating some training points that we can use. That's not that important. This is where the real meat starts, is with this import statement. And if you've programmed in Python before, you're well acquainted with import statements. This is the way that you bring in external modules into the code that you're writing so that you don't have to completely re-implement everything every time. You can use code that someone else has already written. So we say from sklearn.naivebayes, we're going to import Gaussian NB. Very good. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to use that to create a classifier. So classifier equals Gaussian NB. If you miss your import statement, if you forget this line for some reason, then this line is going to throw an error. So if you end up seeing some kind of error that says that it doesn't recognize this function, it's probably a problem with your import statement. So okay, we've created our classifier. So now the code is all sort of ready to go. The next thing that we need to do is we need to fit it. And we've been using the word train interchangeably with fit. So this is where we actually give it the training data and it learns the patterns. So we have the classifier that we've just created. We're calling the fit function on it. And then the two arguments that we pass to fit are x, which in this case are the features, and y, which are the labels. And this is always going to be true in supervised classification, is that it's going to call this fit function and then it's going to have the features and then the labels. And then the last thing that we do is we ask the classifier that we've just trained for some predictions. So we give it a new point. In this case, the point is -0.8, -1. And we ask for this, what do you think the label is for this particular point? Which class does it belong to? So in this particular case, it says it belongs to class number 1, or you could imagine for some other point, it might say class number 2. So of course, you have to have already fit the classifier before you can call predict on it, because when it's fitting the data, that's where it's actually learning the patterns, and then here is where it's using those patterns to make a prediction. So that's it. That's kind of, now you know most all there is to know to get this working in the first example that I've done.